Here comes the ice. I mean, it's building up quick.
I know one of them will help if I can lower or modernize. The winglets and cowling ice up.
We're Lifestyle Aviation, the largest diamond aircraft dealer in the world, and today we're bringing you along one of our Diamond DA40 NG deliveries, flying over 2,000 miles from London, Ontario to Boise, Idaho. In part one of this three-part series, we'll fly to the North American Diamond Aircraft Factory. We'll give you a tour of the aircraft production line while we wait for the weather to clear up. Welcome to part one. It is currently 7:51 a.m. and today we are prepping to go on a cross-country trip from Raleigh, Durham, all the way up to London, Ontario, Canada, picking up a brand new DA40 NG and flying it cross-country to Idaho. So excited that you're coming along with us. This is how Lifestyle Aviation delivers brand new aircraft to people just like you. We are in the plane. We are all loaded up in the 42. And up here we got Mark and Andres as our pilots, and we are headed up to the Diamond Factory. So we will see you up there. The Diamond Factory is about a 3-hour trip from our home base at RDU. It takes careful coordination each time our team makes the trip with many factors to consider. Let's see how Andres prepares for the approach into London.
We've got the weather out London. And they're advertising the RNAV brief approach, and so we're going to brief it. Got the ATIS, already got that. Toronto Center 135.3. We'll be ready for that. We know that we know to expect that about 3/4 of the way past the lake. Safe altitude within 100 nautical miles of the airport, 4,900 feet. And this isn't a standard FAA chart or a Jeppesen chart. This is a Canadian approach plane. So it's a little bit different than what most people are used to. The factory is actually on the approach end of 3-3. Depending on the visibility, you will see it off of the left side. Toronto Center, good morning. November 107, November off 8.8. I'm with the weather on M3.
107, November golf center is 1-8 at India. And check the RNM 3-3, proceed direct dab off.
2991 and direct dab off partner Zulu 3. Just have to remember.
Alright, I'm going to watch your leg. I'm going to slow down a little bit. Just in case it starts getting a little bumpy.
Here comes the ice.
Flying through it, fine. Flying in it, not fine. I mean, it's building up quick.
Icing conditions are often forecasted during the winter months, so our team flies an airplane with flight into known icing equipment, or FIKI for short. This helps us safely land without building up too much ice on the leading edges. But even with this de-icing equipment, it is important to move through the cloud layer quickly in case the conditions are severe.
I'm going to request lower.
Yeah, do it.
Center 107, I'll request lower, moderate ice.
7 November, go up to the fence over now.
4,700.
The airport sits at 912 MSL and receives quite a bit of snowfall each winter.
7 November Golf Tower, wind 2905 knots, third land, runway 33.
Third land, 3376.
Like Andre said, the factory is just off runway 33 at Charlie Yankee X-ray uniform.
Great landing, Mark. Great flying. Always fun.
Alright, we just touched down at the Diamond Factory Airport in London, Ontario. We are on hold right now because we have to go through customs first before we proceed to the factory. But once we get through customs and get there, then we will check out the brand new DA40 NG. Well, we're here at Diamond Aircraft. We made it It's cold outside and snowing, but it's warm inside. This place is beautiful, and I'm here with sales administrator Tony Burrows. And he's gonna give us a little tour of the facility and show us around and just to see what Diamond is up to up here in London, Ontario. So, are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. Let's do it. Okay, so we're in the avionics shop right now. The entire process starts at this end of the room where we've got the raw bundles of wire down here. These are all laser etched for identification. Got some automatic crimping machines here. Typically what happens is they start by building smaller wiring harness bundles, 5 to 10 wires. These will then be quality tested, and then they'll go into boxes where they'll eventually make their way to the tooling boards farther down the room. We also produce the LRU boxes, the line with placeable unit enclosures for the G1000 system. These are also built in-house. This is a complete DA40 instrument panel. You'll notice just how neat and tidy everything is on the back end and how well labeled it all is. So that was the avionics department. As we were discussing, it takes about a month and a half to build up the entire harness system and all the wiring needed to build a DA40. So our next stop in the process is Composite Operations, otherwise known as FRP, for fiberglass reinforced plastics. What sets us apart here is that we use a wet layup process. Other manufacturers will use a dry layup process where they'll typically receive a shipment of pre-impregnated materials, glass cloth, carbon fiber cloth. It'll already have the resin matrix added to it. We avoid any wastage and the costs associated with storing it by producing it on demand like we do here. So this is a DA62 wing spar. We've got the root end right here. We've got the carbon cap top and bottom. And then we've got the foam core web. Once the material is put in place, the laminators here will start to add layers of glass and carbon cloth to help build up the wing spar. They're prepping now to bond the spar and the trailing edge bulkhead onto this lower wing skin assembly. They're putting all the tooling on top to locate all of the ribs and the spars in precisely the exact position. These are the fuel tanks that we use in the DA40s and the 62s. These are all produced here in-house. We've got a very talented welder that puts these together for us. Here's a wing set here. This shows you the two wing spars as they come out of the wing and shows that nice protected area for our fuel tanks. These are fresh out of Composite Operations. They have yet to trim away the excess paste that's been squeezed out along the bond line. This kind of gives you a nice visual on how the two halves have gone together, how that excess paste was squeezed out. This is a visual window into this bonding seam. And we leave this clear because it allows us to actually inspect the amount of paste that has migrated along this bonding flange. This will be very carefully trimmed away in the trim shop in the near future. This is a DA62 center wing section. You'll notice that these are some of the high density foam blocks that we use as part of our crash protection. These high density foam blocks are designed to compress, and in the event of a crash, these foam blocks will absorb a lot of the impact forces. This is a DA40 NG fuselage. They've just recently bonded the center wing section in place. If you come take a look inside here, you'll be able to see how we've strategically positioned extra layers of carbon fiber for the rollover protection. It's part of our 26G occupant safety system. So we actually have two production lines going here. We've got DA20s on this side of the floor, and then we've got DA40s on the left side of the floor. As the aircraft become more complete, and as the wings are fitted on, the two lines merge. This is the beginning of the DA62 line. They generally park the fuselages out here and then they start to do, you know, the initial stages of the interior installation. Notice this one's pretty bare bones. They've just started to lay down the copper shielding in the back. You can see that they've started plumbing in various hoses and lines. You can see one of the autopilot actuator servos in place. They've capped off the high density foam blocks with some red protective covers so they don't get damaged. Plane was merged probably about 3 weeks ago. The engines are on, the avionics are in, the interior panels have been fitted. So that's a quick tour of the factory, and this is the airplane that you're going to be leaving with later today.
When we get to the factory, we look at the entire airplane as a whole, and then we go over inspecting every square inch of this airplane, making sure any defect or any scratch is noted and corrected before we depart.
Coming up in part two of the DA40 NG delivery.
November 254, Lima Alpha, clear for takeoff runway 33.
There's Lake Huron right there, right off to our north side.